It's really an honor to be here and have the chance to ask questions this evening. So my question is, I recently changed my job, but I feel a strong feeling of uncomfortable with my job. Like, I've been like trying many new things and different things lately, and my current job is very different with any other job that I've been doing before. And it's turned out that I don't feel like comfortable doing it, and I also like don't think that I could deliver my best potential here, and I don't think like I'm being fulfilled in this job. Also, I still like don't feel like passionate about what I'm doing right now. So that's often makes me sad, and I think I need time to like taking a break. So I would like to know like your opinion and maybe advice for my situation. Thank you.
네. 자전거 탈 줄 알아요?
Do you know how to ride a bike?
No.
네. 만약에 지금 자전거를 배운다면 그것이 쉽겠습니까? 어렵겠습니까?
Okay, so imagine that you're learning how to ride a bike right now. Do you think that'll be easy or difficult?
Difficult.
그럼 자전거를 잘 타는 사람들은 자전거 타는 게 쉬울까요? 어려울까요?
But for those who are good riders, do you think it's easy for them to ride a bike or not?
It will be difficult too, I think.
네, 피아노 칠 줄 압니까?
Do you know how to play the piano?
No.
네, 지금 만약에 배운다면 쉬울까요, 어려울까요?
So if you had to learn it today, do you think it'll be difficult or easy?
It also will be difficult.
그럼 피아노를 잘 항상 치는 피아니스트는 어떻겠어요? 피아노 치는 게 쉬울까요, 어려울까요?
However, for somebody who's been playing for a long time, a professional pianist, do you think playing piano is easy or difficult for that person?
It will be easy.
네. 그러면 자기는 농구 할 줄 압니까?
Do you know how to play a basketball?
Not really, I think.
네, 농구 할 줄 모르는 사람이 농구를 배운다면 쉬울까요? 처음에 어려울까요?
For a beginner, you know, if you had to learn how to play basketball in the beginning, do you think it'll be easy or difficult?
For a beginner, it will be like difficult.
네, 그럼 농구 선수는 농구 하는 게 어떻게 쉬울까요? 어려울까요?
But for a professional basketball player, would it be difficult for that person to play basketball or not?
For a professional basketball player, it will easier for them.
Yeah. 처음 만나는 사람이 더 편안합니까? 여러 번 만났던 사람이 더 편안합니까?
Do you feel more comfortable with when meeting a stranger or when seeing somebody you're already familiar with?
It would be more comfortable seeing someone that we are all familiar with.
자, 이런 대화에서 왜 처음 하는 일은 어려울까요?
So having this conversation, why do you think it's difficult to do a first-time job for the first time?
I think because we don't have like a skill yet and like knowledge about what we are doing in the job and we are not like used to doing that.
네. 자기는 여행을 갈 때 늘 갔던 곳에 가고 싶습니까? 새로운 곳에 가고 싶습니까?
So when you go on a trip, do you want to go back to the place you always go, or do you want to go to a new place?
If I'm going to trip, I think I want to like going to new place, trying to new things.
왜 늘 가던 익숙한 곳에 안 가고 왜 어려운 새로운 곳에 가려고 합니까?
Then why don't you want to go back to the place that you always go to instead of going to a strange new place?
I think because I want to experience more. Like, I also want to go back to the like the first place that I visited, but I also like want to try any new things that I never been before.
당신은 늘 같은 책을 읽고 싶습니까? 다른 책도 책을 바꿔가면서 다른 책을 읽고 싶습니까?
So when reading a book, do you want to read the same book all over again, or maybe pick up a new book?
I would love to like trying to read another book and also reread my the old book that I love. But of course, I want to like reading new book that might be interested.
늘 똑같은 책을 읽으면 내용도 다 알고 아주 쉬운데 왜 어려운 일을 하려 합니까?
But if you read the same book all over again, you already know how the story goes and it's really easy for you to read. So why do you want to go through the difficulty of reading a new book?
Because I want to know like another story that will be like written in a book at like adventure that I want to like find in a new book that I will be reading.
그럼 우리의 대화 속에서 우리는 이런 특징을 발견할 수가 있습니다.
So as we have this dialogue, we can find out a few things.
늘 하던 일은 익숙하지만은 새로운 것을 배울 수는 없다.
So things we already know how to do, we're familiar with it. But there's nothing new for us to learn.
새로운 것은 처음 하는 일은 어색하고 어렵고 불편하고 그러지만은 새로운 지식, 새로운 기술, 새로운 사람 뭔가 더 많은 것을 배울 수가 있다.
But if we try new things, you know, anytime we do something for the first time, it's very difficult, awkward, and it's, you know, it takes time. But we can learn new things or meet new people.
근데 우리는 새로운 걸 하라 그러면 처음 한 일이라서 어렵다고 말하고 익숙한 일을 하라 그러면 늘 하던 일이라서 재미가 없다 이렇게 말합니다.
However, when people tell us to do new things, we say that this is new, this is difficult, and it is hard to do. But when people say, you know, go ahead, do the old things, we say we're already familiar. This is boring, and I'm not having fun.
이렇게 새로운 걸 시켜 처음 하는 일을 시켜도 즉 처음 하는 일을 시켜도 어려워서 싫다 그러고 늘 하던 일을 하라 그러면 재미없다 그러고 그래서 늘 불평입니다.
So we're always complaining because if we are asked to do new things, we say no. It's unfamiliar. It's difficult. When we are asked to do continue with the old thing, we go, well, this is hard. Oh, the old thing, we say, this is boring, and I'm not learning anything new.
그러니까 처음 하는 일은 약간 익숙하지 못해서 약간 어렵기는 하지만은 배움이 있습니다.
But anytime we do a thing for the first time, it's somewhat unfamiliar because we haven't done it before, but there's learning attached to it.
그 다음에 하던 일은 조금 배우는 건 없지만은 그래도 편안하고 익숙한 좋은 점이 있습니다.
But if we continue with the old thing, we're not learning anything new, but it is familiar, it is comfortable.
이렇게 서로 다른 측면이 있다는 겁니다.
So there are two sides to old things.
그러니까 내가 선택을 하려면 불평불만을 하게 되고 주어지는 것을 받아들이면 어느 쪽이든 불평불만이 없다는 거예요.
So if somebody asks us to do something, either or, new or old, we tend to complain because there are two sides to the same thing. But if we make a choice ourselves, then there's no complaint.
다시 말하면 새로운 일이 주어지면 재밌겠다 연구하면서 하는 자세를 취하면 됩니다.
So in other words, if somebody gives you something new to do, then you should bring the attitude that, wow, this should be fun. It's something new I'm learning.
그러나 여기에는 익숙하지 못한 불편함을 감수해야 합니다.
But at the same time, you have to deal with the consequences of being unfamiliar, uncomfortable with it at first.
그것을 어렵게 생각하지 말고 배움이라고 생각하고 재밌다, 신기하다 이렇게 접근해야 합니다.
So instead of thinking, approaching a new thing with a sense of difficulty and unfamiliar, you should approach it with a sense of excitement, a sense of learning something new, sense of the fantastic.
늘 하던 일을 반복하게 될 때는 익숙해서 좋다, 편해서 좋다, 잘할 수 있어서 좋다 이렇게 받아들여야 합니다.
But if they ask you to do something old, then the attitude you should bring is that this is familiar. I'm comfortable with this. I'm really good at this.
그래서 새로운 일이든 처음 일이든 참 처음 하는 일이든 익숙한 일이든 늘 우리에게는 아무런 어려움이 없습니다. 불편이 없습니다.
Therefore, whether it's something new, whether it's something old they ask you to do, then there's no complaint.
그러니까 새로운 직장을, 새로운 일을, 새로운 곳에 여행 간다 이렇게 생각하시면 어떨까요?
So when you go to a new job, you're doing something new. You're learning something new. You're going to a different, new, exciting location. How about approaching it that way?
Either way, they will be like complain, but I think I know that the new point about the two choices about going to new job or staying or maybe like doing a job that I feel familiar about, something like that.
지혜로운 선택은 어느 것을 해도 좋다. 이게 지혜로운 선택입니다.
So a wise choice is a choice that whatever choice you make, you feel that it's a good choice?
For now, I think I will be more comfortable to doing something that I already good at. Like I already having that skill and knowledge about that area of job.
네, 그것은 늘 구경하던 곳만 구경하고 싶다. 것과 같습니다.
So that's the same thing as you saying that, you know, I want to continue watching the same thing I've been watching.
Yes.
그건 지루합니다.
But it could get boring.
I think no, I know like the consequences that if I choosing like the route that familiar. It will like eventually become more boring, but because I know the consequences about it, then I think I will have like a more thoughtful mind about that and not to complain about like doing the same thing or the same route over again.
그러면 잘 하는 것으로 돌아가면 되지 않습니까?
네, 지금 잘하는 것으로 돌아간다고
예, 자기가 익숙한 걸 좋아한다고 하니까 그러면 새로운 직장을 그만두고 원래 익숙한 곳으로 돌아가서 하면 되지 않느냐는 거죠.
Since you like to do the familiar, so I think then why don't you quit your current job, which is a new job that you're unfamiliar with, and go back to what you've been doing before.
Okay. I want to try new things, but when I'm trying new things like in my current job, then I like trying to like know more about myself, but what I like doing and what I really want in my life. So when I having this like concern and having this thing into my mind, I think I kind of decided that I want to doing the things that I used to and I'm familiar with. So this idea and this concern, I think like it's like an output or a result about what I'm currently thinking now, that like a result about the job that I'm currently in. So because I'm trying a new thing at my new job, and I feel like this is, I think, not the right for me, then I have that thinking and I have that idea that I think I should pursue like what I'm familiar, I'm good with.
안 맞는 게 아니라 익숙하지가 않는 거예요.
So it's not that you're not a good fit for your new job. It's just that you're still unfamiliar with it.
어떤 것도 처음 할 때는 익숙할 수가 없습니다.
You know, whatever you do, you can't be familiar with it from the start.
그것에 대해서 반복해서 여러 번 하고 거기에 대한 많은 지식을 점점 갖게 되면 익숙해집니다.
You know, after repeating the job, after having been doing it and, you know, gaining knowledge, that's how you become familiar with it.
그러니까 이 말을 내가 다시 할 테니까 잘 들어보세요.
So I'm going to try to restate what I just said.
내가 익숙한 것을 원하면 익숙한 것을 선택하면 됩니다.
And if you want the familiar, then you can just choose the familiar.
내가 새로운 것을 원하면 새로운 것을 선택하면 됩니다.
If you want the new, you can choose the new.
새로운 것을 선택했을 때는 익숙하지 못하기 때문에 어려움이 있습니다.
But if you choose the new, you're not familiar with it, and there's difficulty there.
그것은 이미 새로움을 선택할 때 당연히 따라오는 것입니다.
That difficulty is a natural consequence of you choosing the new.
새로운 걸 하고 싶고 익숙하게 하고 싶다. 이거는 될 수가 없는 일입니다.
But if you choose the new, but you want to be familiar with it, that's a contradiction you can't overcome.
그것은 욕심입니다.
And that is desire, that's greed.
그러니까 새로운 것을 선택할 때, 익숙하지 못한 것 때문에 불편이 올 때, 이 새로운 것에 대한 이 단점을 생각하지 말고 장점을 생각하라는 거예요.
So when you choose a new and the inevitable unfamiliarity comes with it, don't think of the negative, but focus on the positive of the new.
조금 어렵지만은 연습을 하면 익숙해진다. 그리고
For example, it's a little difficult, but it's going to get better the more I get used to it, the more I practice.
또 이것은 연구를 해야 된다.
Second, this gives me an opportunity to further develop myself, to research.
그리고 나의 기술과 지식이 넓어진다.
My skill set and my knowledge base is going to get better.
그리고 이것은 재미가 있다.
And last, this is fun.
마치 새로운 것을 여행하는 같은 마음을 내야 됩니다.
So approach the new task as if you're going on a trip to a strange, new, exotic place.
그러니까 그것을 내가 선택했거나 나에게 주어졌거나 새로운 것일 때는 이런 관점을 가져야 합니다.
So whether somebody told you to do something new or whether you chose to do something new, whenever you end up doing something new, this is the approach you should bring to it.
근데 그게 아무리 지식과 기술이 넓어진다 하더라도 내가 어려움이 너무 크다면 포기하고 익숙한 것을 선택해야 합니다.
But no matter how better your knowledge or skill set becomes, if the difficulty is too much, then you have to give it up and go back to the familiar.
내가 잘할 수 있는 일이니까 편안한 것은 맞습니다.
And since you are familiar with it, you know you're already good with it and you're comfortable with it.
근데 왜 자기가 새로운 것을 선택했을까요?
Then why did you choose to go to a new job?
거기는 뭔가 자기가 미래 더 나은 어떤 희망을 가질 수 있었기 때문일 겁니다.
That's because you probably saw a new future, a new possibility in your future with a new job.
그러니까 그 희망, 그 미래를 향해서 나아가든지 안 그러면 현실에 안주하든지 그것은 본인의 선택입니다.
So whether you will continue exploring that new future or whether you want to go back to the familiar, that's up to you. That's your choice.
질문자는 자전거를 타고 싶어서 또는 자전거를 시작했는데 몇 번 넘어지니까 자전거가 나한테 안 맞다. 지금 이렇게 생각하는 거예요.
So what you're thinking is that you want to learn to ride a bike. But when you fell off several times riding a bike, you're saying that, you know, maybe bike riding is not for me.
이렇게 넘어질 바에야 걸어가는 게 낫다.
So, you know what? Rather than fall off, hurt myself riding a bike, I'd rather walk.
그러면 걸어가십시오.
Then it's your choice to walk.
그러나 자전거를 배우면 배우는 과정에서 어려움이 있지만 배우고 나면 훨씬 더 편리함이 있습니다.
But although it's difficult to learn to ride a bike in the first time, but after you learn to ride a bike, there is convenience that comes with riding a bike.
그러나 거기는 넘어지는 그런 어려운 과정을 반드시 겪어야 합니다.
But before you get that convenience, you have to pay the price of difficulty of falling down while riding a bike.
젊을 때는 새로운 도전이 더 낫고 나이가 들면 새로운 도전보다는 비교적 익숙한 것을 하는 게 더 낫습니다.
So while you're still young, going after a new challenge is probably better. And if you get older, as you get older, maybe staying put with what you know best is the better choice.
지금 당신 나이가 그 중간에 적 어중간하기 때문에 이런 고민이 생기는 것 같아.
I think you might be caught in the middle of that age group. That's why you're, you know, having difficulty making a choice.
네.
Yes, I want to try new things like going over like my comfort zone. That your answer is really helpful. I know the consequence about like trying a new route and stay the familiar route, and I think it's really helpful for me and for I making like a better decision and also like for knowing what best and what I really want in my life.
Thank you. 네. 자, 그러면 소감 한번 얘기해 보세요.
If you have any follow-on comments, please.
Okay. I'm really thankful about this conversation. I think I know myself better, and I'm really grateful to be in this process. Thank you.